one-on-one competition. That's what I like, you and him, just one-on-one. That's my favorite thing about it.
How do you get used to getting hit in the face?
Repetition.
This may look brutal, it might seem barbaric, but MMA has taken what looks like a street fight and brought it to mainstream America.
What fight is on? Right now, I am not the one in the ring.
I wear a suit and tie during the day, and I come here and change clothes and then get all hot and sweaty.
Being a certain type of athlete is not a requirement. Football players, kickboxers, martial arts experts, they all can be found at Full Force Academy. The only requirement?
Best thing I can tell you is heart.
Heart.
This is heart. I said, I know you're tired. I know you're hard. I know that you're working hard. But there's going to be several times in life that things are going to get hard, that you're going to be tired. You just got to keep punching. You've got to keep going.
With virtually no rules in its infancy, MMA was outlawed on television sets across the country. But with a change in ownership and a strict safety guideline for fighters, MMA elbowed its way into popular culture.
It is exactly like a street fight with gloves on and a referee. It's just that there's a point in time in this particular fight a guy can tap out. You can't tap out in a street fight or bar fight.
It's one thing to talk about MMA, it's another thing to try.
After 7.2 seconds in the cage, I realized that the title of MMA fighter was not in my cards, but the dream lives on for the students at Full Force.
Our trainers taught us different. We always set the standard high. You know, he wants us, you know, go pro or somewhere of that level. And, you know, and he tells us, if you show the true dedication, he's got the skills and, you know, we'll make it.
With critics still wary of MMA because of its raw brutality, the reality is that the street fight has kicked down the door and made its way into our living rooms. For KNOE 8 Sports, I'm Nima Yazdani. With the bright lights of the Superdome shining from up above, Destiny managed to find its way into the Superdome last Saturday night. Two cities, 300 miles apart, found themselves united, rooting for each other in their respective state championship games.
The main thing I said, I wanted our quarterback, Riz Turner, to do well, and my former quarterback, Randall Mackler, to do well.
July of 2006, TV8 went to Port Sol for almost a year after Hurricane Katrina, only to find the city in ruins, corroded buses on the side of the road, abandoned houses and school zones. What was once a thriving community was now a ghost town.
For a lot of these kids, the only thing they had was school and athletics. And then most of them, at the end of the day, was going back to FEMA trailers.
Randall Mackey at the time was Port Sulphur's star sophomore quarterback, in line to cement his legacy, following a brother who had won a state title of his own. But the hurricane whisked him 300 miles north to Bastrop, where he never lost a game on the field.
But this is my dad's house game, so I'm just, you know, just excited.
While Mackey was setting records, Coach Crutchfield stayed in Port Sulphur, determined to build a winner.
I'm in here for the long haul. You won't see Cyril Crutchfield anywhere else but down here in Plaquemines Parish. I thought it would have been Port Sulphur, but it would be South Plaquemines.
Port Sulphur consolidated with two other schools to form the South Plaquemines Hurricanes.
Bad things will happen. You will possibly lose a job or lose a loved one or go through a divorce. You know, and it's not really what you're going to do when that happened. It's basically what you're going to do after that happens.
And the kids and coaching staff responded.
Remember, this has been a very emotional day for Mackey. As you mentioned, Coach Foster, here's a guy who would have played for South Plaquemines if he had stayed there after Katrina. South Plaquemines with a dominant win in 1A today. No doubt happy to see his neighbors and his friends from Basel win the state championship and then come back and win the state championship on his own.
That's just family, you know. We just came together. That's how it is.
I don't know what to say. Just means so much to us growing up and stuff. And this has always been a dream, and it just came true.
And for South Plaquemines and Bastrop, Destiny had a way of turning those dreams into reality. For TV8 Sports, I'm Nima Yazdani.